Okay, what would be the aim for this session is, the first one is green print. Okay, what is green print? Why you need to green print? And how to green print? Okay, it's not talking about you change the white to green color. Okay, something that relate to environment part. The second area is that, as usual, you realize a green print clinic. Okay, clinic. Ask your questions. If you go to see a doctor, so you have flu, you have cough, you need to see the doctors. And doctor will give you an advice. That's why they call later on, there's a framework called actions. And you have like a condition that you have high blood pressures or diabetic, you need to do a follow-up. Same thing, we do have the same frameworks. And the next step is how we can help you to manage your print-related issue later on. Okay, this I'll give you a this is the agenda. I'll give you a short introduction about Xerox and what is green print and what is benefit about green print and how to green print. There's an online tool and what is next. Okay, I just give you introductions. In Malaysia, last time it known 48 years ago, it known as those early, in 60s, it's known as Rank Xerox. Rank Xerox. That's the oldest name, the Rank Xerox, between Xerox Corporations and company in UK. Back in 90s, Fujifilm bought over the share from Xerox Corporations. So Fujifilm is our parent company. So they own 75% of Fuji Xerox and 25% by Xerox Corporations. That's why known as Fuji Xerox. So we established back in 1960s. We have capital about 20 billion yen. And our employees currently in Asia Pacific, we have 45,000, and 40% of them are non-Japanese, and 40% of business come from non-Japanese countries. That means another Asia Pacific region, including Malaysia's. And 90% of product is produced in China. We have two places, one in Shenzhen, one in Shanghai. And we're going to open actually another plant in November in Vietnam. Because last year we are facing an issues, the crisis between two countries. Realize what this contract, two countries? Issue of one small island. I think you know about that. Okay? So even also there's a crisis, also natural disasters. You know, about tsunamis, flood, and also earthquake. That's why we opened another plant in Vietnam to cater business. Okay, this is my current president, Yamamoto-san. And this is the quote he mentioned. Sustainability is not additional to our business. It's simply how we run our business. It's fundamental to how we lead Europe into the futures. And this is what we are doing now. And just to mention, we actually moved to the new office, not far from here. And we actually embedded in all the solution and latest products. And this can be showcased to the customer. Next year, you can see us in January, not far from here, 10 minutes away. And this also help how we can help the customer to use our solutions later on. And this is actually the entire value change. We realized actually we look into from the supplier up to the environment parts. So we look at each category, basically the impact to the environment and impact to the communities. So we actually buy from the suppliers and how we have a program with the employees and also for the customers, because we ensure that the product they use actually is safe energy and also safe for human beings to use. And at the end of the day, it's our responsibility to collect back all the used products or the used machines or used toner cartridge from the customer, because we have an objective for that part, zero landfill. Because, for example, in Malaysia, we have a big issue about landfill. So we don't want that our product be landed to that land. Because you know that if that or other, or not other earth actually, that product actually been situated there and affected, and most important is affected the water. At the end, it's affected us. So we don't want to happen. That's why we have actually an objective zero landfill. So what for today's session is, I'm going to emphasize on this part. We do have a program to manage the environment part in the Fuji Xerox, but we do have a bigger role to help the customers. Because we have a target by, you know, we have a vision 2020 already, kan? Okay, we do have a vision 2020. What is the vision? Is to reduce 30% of CO2 from the beginning of the product until end of life. 30% reduction. Because why CO2? Because CO2 is the major culprit in terms of global warming. Okay, we play a small role, I know. We play a small role, but if we each other can lend a hand, we can help a better world. Okay, what's green print? Any ideas you want to try? Just throw ideas. Without paper, we call it no paper or paperless. No? Okay? Any ideas? Okay, let me go to the next one, okay? It means is to manage, or ideally is to reduce there's print-related issues, printing-related issues. The first one, the energy. The second one, the waste, and also the print. So what is talking about the energy here? I mean, you're using an energy-saving device. Second one, to reduce the waste. What sort of waste are talking about here? The toner cartridge, the paper that you use, and also, most fundamental part, most of the company actually, if they have all kind of device, printer, office product, and actually owned by individual people. So we actually need to have actually that device, the right number of device, appropriate to the numbers of employees. The second one is talking about prints, the numbers, print volumes is talking about. Okay, let me go to why is green print. Okay, this is actually the study being done the past 10 years. And most significant part is these areas. Enterprise will spend 3% of their revenue on document output alone. And last 2 years, we showcased about this one. Just one workers, produce 10,000 page off per year. If you can't imagine it, imagine it's as high as this building. That is, and can fill up through this hole. It's a lot of paper being waste. And just an easy method, you can actually reduce the printing cost by 30 to 30%. What I mentioned talking about print, energy, and waste actually is you can manage the cost substantially. And that is a benefit later on. This one part, cost saving about 10 to 30%. Just a simple solutions that you can do. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, how to green print? Okay, this is actually the fundamental framework that I mentioned. If you want to see doctors, there's area you need to do check up. Doctor will give you medication and also doctor will do follow up. So we do have framework in that case. Okay, we do manage the area. Check up. Check up your print environments now, your print landscape. Analyze your print volume, analyze your energy, analyze your waste, and also looking on the cost that related to financial and also environments. And we actually carry out the action that related to the checkup later on, and we're going to do a review and improve. The most fundamental part, the constant process is, it's most important is the people. You must get people involvement in this part. And most important part is from the top management, that's most important, up to the frontliners, in order the green print to work. Okay, so I need some volunteers to we do a simple checkup. Okay, I ask a question later on. Okay, this is actually the tools that we use. It's actually a very fast checkup to know your print environment, print-related issues. Okay, this is introductions. So the first question is talking on energy. So any volunteers want to try? Just three questions only. Okay? The first question, are all devices in the organization Energy Star compliance where applicable? Some, huh? Okay, has your organization minimized the numbers of single function devices and install multifunctional device? For example, you have a lot of device, then actually you segregate into actually only 5 or 6 devices, some areas. Okay. This is talking about your organization printing device to set a low power mode at off-peak time of the day. That means your device actually at energy saving mode all the time. Some areas. Okay. Let's see the summary. Okay. So you're actually in an area of building. So there's an opportunity you to improve. So there'll be a tips 1, tips 2, tips 3. So I won't go that part. You can actually visit our booth to go to the details. You go to the next questions. Okay, second question is talking about the print area. Anyone could try, sir? Are your device innovation duplex capability? That means it can print double-sided. Because most of the time, company will print single-sided, but can it print double-sided? How about yours? Is it can? Awesome. Okay, anyone to try the questions? No. Okay, no, eh? Okay, does your organization have a responsible paper resources policy in place? Yes. Okay, this question, do you understand this question or not? That means is whatever your paper you purchase from reliable resources. So there's two in the world that certify papers, PEFC and FSCS, Forest Steward Council. It's like the ISO standard. So yes, eh? Sure? Yes, eh? Okay. Okay, next one. Have a user pay or follow me print management. That means it's using a card before in order to get your printing. No. Okay. So you're just starting. So there's a lot of areas of improvement on that areas. Okay, let's go to the last questions actually. On the waste. Anyone to try? How about ladies at the back? Anyone? You? Ken? Okay, this organization have a cartridge recycling program. Can try? Anyone want to try these questions? No. No, huh? Okay. Does your organization have a disposal program for devices at the end of life? That means your product, actually someone, actually we collect it and send to the recycling plant. Yes. No? No, no. Okay, no. Okay. Are paper recycling station easily accessible in your organizations? Okay, yes. Okay. So this is give you a starting, and let's see what is the whole summary actually. You can see the whole summary from print on these areas, okay? Your energy, print also. So there's an area of opportunity you want to improve, whether you want to improve in terms of energy, in terms of print, in terms of waste, okay? I'll show you actually another slide. Okay, this is the framework you see just now. This is the checkup. Okay. So after that is just only what we call initial checkup. So we can have another tools that, but it depends to the size of organizations. So we have to have an advanced assessments to look entire your documents. Who manage it, whom anyone to monitor it, do you know the cost? So we do have a tools of the parts. And after you have check up, it's time to do actions. Action is related on these areas. Okay? So your question is, are your product is star compliance in terms of waste, any recycling program being done or not? In terms of device, is it a print duplex? So that is the actions. So after the action is review and then improve. So in order this program to be successful, okay, you have to be monitor. Same thing like you have the ISO standard, 9041 standard. You have it, but you need to monitor your KPI. Same thing with the green print. So there's a program. Is it anyone manage to monitor the energy consumptions? How much consumable they waste? That means how much toner that you waste? And also, is it any paper reductions? So this is the ongoing programs. Ongoing programs. And the most fundamental that part I mentioned to you is this thing cannot work because there's a people involvement. The most important part is from the top management up to the frontliners. And question is, who can help you this part? The next one is what we need to do and also what might this benefit to them. I give you actually a few people that you can engage in your organizations. For example, your IT, your procurement, your sustainability officers, and also CEO and end user. The most important people is in these guys. This one. These people need to buy in your ideas first. And this is actually the process of the engagement during the checkup. And most important is you need to get the green light from the senior management. And later on, in order this thing to work, okay, and we can actually advise customers to have the committee. It's very important because it's people. And you know that mindset is the most difficult to actually to change. So it must be an ongoing program. So you need a committees. From then, you need to do announcements. And you need to actually collect the information. And also, there's also a people involved. And also, they also like join and also feedback to the print committee. And remember this one. In order this to work, there's called 5 C's. Not the Malaysia cash condo, this one, eh? But this one, another 5 C's. Okay? It's clear. Conversations, continuous, champion, and consistence in order your green print to work. And this is actually a review process whereby that there's a road committee, a report, a survey, and also you must give a reward if you're able to achieve. So normally what we do is, if your target is not achieved, normally what we do is we give punishment, correct me or not. We tend to punish people, we tend to penalize that people, but not that way. You should give them actually how to improve. That's why they here called continuous improvement. Okay, so there's all engagement tools, communications, trainings, formal procedures. Okay, this is actually another case study done by the in Singapore. So this is actually the CIO. And from that green print clinics, okay, he able to reduce about 5 million Sing dollar. Just a simple process. Okay? A simple process, what I mean is to install the print card. What I mean is follow it. You just install the card there. That means is before the job release, you need to go to that device and release the job. Because there's a case that normally if release a job, your document tend to be someone took it, missing. And this normal common one is error. You realize there's a mistake, then you go to your device, key in again, and you print. So you realize there's a waste, a lot of waste. Okay? And that waste for the management is called a cost. A cost. Okay? Even one page, if you imagine just now 10,000. If I put there 10 cents, how much is that? Still a lot of money for one employee. That's a lot. Okay? And what's next? So are you ready? So if you want to find further, you can visit our booth at Hall 4. You can see the green print. Okay? So thank you.